Wake up, wake up. It's time to rise and sing the praise of Jesus. Alleluia, alleluia.
It's time to rise,
to rise,
to sing,
to shout,
to shout,
to bring him all your heart.
He'll do the bigger part
if you will only make a start.
Now what good is a lamp without any oil?
And what good is a life if we struggle and toil? But I cannot see God's...
Here in this corner, for the good and the right, stands a champion robed in white.
Good evening, dear brothers and sisters. The Worship at the Doorstep Ministry wished to extend its ministry covering now four significant worship fora. Number one, the Vespers Testimonies every Friday night. Number two, the Sabbath School Faith Fuels every Saturday early morning. Number three, the Divine Messages Saturday late mornings, and now the newly included Midweek Questions every Wednesday night. It is our hope that these advocacies and services that we are doing for God will also bless His people in the continued new normal societal principle that we are learning to adopt in our community. Shall we first bow our heads for prayer? Our Father which art in heaven, Lord, be with us as we will have our midweek prayer meeting through the midweek five questions. May your will be done, Lord, at ours. Help us to remain healthy, help us to remain strong, and help us to have a pleasant service for thy cause this evening. May thy will be done at ours. In the loving name of Jesus we pray. Amen. So, why five questions? Well, the idea of our midweek program is to identify a focus topic. It can be one that will be randomly generated or can be chosen from the suggestions of our streamers and viewers who wants to suggest a topic to be discussed in five questions. So the mechanics will just be giving the point in five questions based on the Bible and our Christian experiences and missionary lineages. This midweek, we will be tackling the topic friendship. Our K-text is found in Proverbs 27 verse 9. It says, "A sweet friendship refreshes the soul." And this will be discussed under the topic, five questions in Christian friendship. First question, in treating and prioritizing our friends, what would be the general principle? Our text is found in Luke 9 verse 23, and it says, "If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me." So here is the answer to the first question. The verse, or this verse, is the root line where the concept joy or joy was derived. The idea of self-denial and selflessness beyond selfishness is also seen in this verse. So how do we prioritize our friends? It is very simple. J-O-Y principle. Jesus first, He should be our greatest priority. O, others next. Denial of self is a sign of humility and perseverance of a Christian. And Y, you. Last, self is also important. It should not be neglected. It should be used for the glory of God. So this is how we will prioritize friends in the context of who will be more important in the disposal of our time.
Second question. In finding of friends, where will the home and the social friends rank? What happens first and what is last? Our text is found in Luke 2:52, and it says, "And Jesus grew in wisdom and in stature and in favor with God and with men."
Now the answer to the second question. Let us examine the verse Luke 2:52. "And Jesus grew in wisdom," that is mental, "and in stature," that is physical, "and in favor with God," that is spiritual, "and man," that is social. So the order is mental, physical, spiritual, then social. Now if we will rank the order of friendship, it starts with mother for the mental, family for the physical, household for worship, and that is spiritual, and friends outside is social, which will be the last. The reason for this is the child needs first to learn through an ideal friendship at home with the family and with God. If there is already a concept of this kind of friendship, then the child can go out and can select or choose who will be his or her friends.
Third question. Is it a real and dependable fact that friendship is expected to be more trusted and deep when it is in a blood relationship? Our text for consideration is found in Proverbs 18:24. It says, "For there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother."
Now the answer to the third question. The Bible is pointing out that affiliations and relations are just possible due to reproduction and segregation of society. However, the fact of having friends depends a lot in the experience, training, education, and God-fearing attitudes of man. Even the Bible discredits the point that blood is thicker than water. The Bible proves that the true friendship can happen to everyone and anyone regardless of the life affiliations and relations. That is why it says, "For there are friends that sticks closer than a brother."
Fourth question. What is the role and indication of a true friend in terms of the Bible principle? Is this the person who will always make you smile, or the person who will call the right as right and the wrong as wrong? Our text for consideration is Proverbs 27:17. It says, "You use steel to sharpen steel, and one friend sharpens another."
Now for question number 4, the answer is, friendship is not a mouthpiece of appreciation, even if there is nothing to appreciate. Friendship is the ability to tell the hard truth that common people cannot do. That is when you call a friend a true friend by its term. In this contextualization, effective friends are friends that needs your help and friends that you help. So if you are learning from your friends and your friends learn from you, then the verse we use is accurately exemplified. The problem is if we go with friends that we know are pulling us to the negative pressure and ones that we cannot get anything but negation of the truth, then we are with the wrong friends.
Fifth question. What should we do with friends that are actually stabbing us at our backs and are considering us as their enemy when we are not present? Our text for consideration is Matthew 5:44. It says, "But I say to you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which spitefully use you and persecute you."
Now the answer for the last question, question number 5. Quite the opposite of what we think will God let us do, but you see it right, to your enemies. So to your enemies, love them, do good, and pray for them. Oftentimes we call this as martyrdom. But my mom before told me, "Noy, when people are hurling wrong things to you, smile and tell them, God bless you, and they will feel having live charcoals in their heads. True to my mom's logic, it is really working. If we do bad to people who are doing bad, that is objectives fulfilled for them. But if we will not do bad to people who are doing bad, instead we will do good for them with evil purposes, this will lead them to think of the things that they are doing and they might reflect and change their ways. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, these are just five sensible questions about Christian friendship. God is the greatest model of friendship. His relationship with His Father, His relationship with His disciples, His relationship with His brothers and sisters, and His relationship with the community He is meeting are all exemplary evidences that God's modeling is in fact the best basis for friendship in this world. Let us continue our study about Christian friendship with a true story about a Filipino surfer named Roger. Roger is a trained Filipino competitor in the Southeast Asian Games. The ultimate goal of the course is to let the other competitors be under you to win the gold. During the actual competition, Roger already noticed the unstable winds. Surfing is a dangerous sport if the winds will not cooperate. However, the competition continued. Surfers are now on the water and they are there ready to start. There was a big wave that shattered the competitors while they are doing the surfing routines, and Roger is on course to win the gold medal. But as he resumed his visuals, he saw the Indonesian competitor out of balance and grasping for dear life. Roger did not hesitate. He prayed so quick and dived to that human needing help, a friend in need, and give up the chance to win the gold. Yes, Roger fulfilled the principle of J-O-Y or joy. Jesus first, others next, and his ambitions last. To shorten the story, Roger did not finish with a gold, but he saved a life of a friend, and to him that is more memorable than all the golds he win in the Southeast Asian Games. Brethren, have you experienced already real friendship? If you have, then you are very lucky. If you have not, then it's time to experience one of the nicest experiences in life, and that is to have true friendship. The experience to trust a friend. May the love of our greatest friend be with us in this great middle of the week. Have a great midweek, everyone. Have a great friendship to all. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Permit me to pray for you, dear brothers and sisters, as we end our midweek services this evening. Our Father who is in heaven, the greatest model of friendship for humanity, Lord, this moment we are opening our hearts to you. Bless us with the spirit of being a true friend. Terminate our feelings of jealousy, hatred, and competition. Replace this, Lord, with love and humility. Lord, be with us in this life that we are continuing to journey. We ask all these things in the loving name of Jesus we pray. Amen. See you again, dear brothers and sisters, next week in our midweek in quarantine. This is still a Worship at the Doorstep ministry under the Jervin Eagle Religious Literary Inspirational Productions. This is your midweek host, Brother Prose Gonzaga Jr., till the next questions will be asked. This is my prayer. He is higher than